Eliana Alexander is an award-winning actress and a writer, and her latest role in Perpetual Grace, Ltd. has her working opposite Ben Kingsley and also Luis Guzman, who plays her husband. And she's also an author, but we're going to talk more about that later. I just want to welcome Eliana Alexander.
Thank you.
Bienvenida.
Gracias. It's good to be here.
I'm so excited about your role in the epic Perpetual Grace.
Yes. Perpetual Grace Ltd. is amazing because it's Sir Ben Kingsley. He's been knighted. It's his first television series.
Wow.
So how lucky am I to get to be a part of that?
Yeah.
It follows James, who is a grifter, and he preys on Pastor Brown, Pa, which is Sir Ben Kingsley, and then he realizes he's a lot more dangerous than he thinks. So it is a wonderful film noir, but it's set up for television noir.
Is it a period piece?
Not a period piece, but it's just really stylized.
Right. And I love the fact that they incorporate Latino characters because we need to be in more shows. Talk to us about the plot and how you and
your family.
Comes into play in the show.
Yes, I play Marisol Contreras, who is married to Hector Contreras, played by Luis Guzman, and he is so much fun to work with. He's always cracking up. I mean, you can't keep a straight face, but then we pull it all together. So the whole family is a lot of fun. I want to give a shout out also to Calvin Benuto, who plays Matthias, my son, and Alonso Alvarez, who plays Emil. I play Marisol, very strong woman, very proactive with her family. She believes in family values, and you will see throughout the series how brave she becomes and how she fights. I can't say too much, but how she fights for her family.
So you're not the typical characters that Latinas get, like three lines and you're gone.
No, I'm in there. I'm in there. So I'm really happy about that. And the story is integral. Every scene has a beautiful arc, and the thread throughout the whole scene incorporates all of us, intertwines all of us. So we are in throughout the whole story, and we really support Luis's story.
Right.
And it is a good one.
And I'm glad that you said that it's a brave character, and you've done brave roles in the past. For example, your role in Sinvergüenza, which was so important for our community, and it's still important. Talk to us about that project.
Sinvergüenza was a lot of fun because, one, at first I didn't understand what we were trying to convey, and then when I got the full script, the powerful meaning behind that, as an actor get to be a part of something that helps people, brings community together, allows families and people to come out of their shell and talk about whatever they need.
Right.
That was powerful.
And the storyline, for people that don't know, is about this family and the mother, which is you, contract AIDS.
Yes.
And you don't know how that happens, and I don't want to ruin it for people, but it's a lot of taboo things in the Latino community that you never discuss. And that is done in a way to help community address some of these issues.
Some of the issues, yes. Mm-hmm. My character, Adriana, she contracts HIV. So she doesn't get full-blown AIDS.
Okay, good.
And it teaches you how to stay positive and healthy.
And you're also an author.
Right.
Mm-hmm. Right. So I wanted to ask you about that. What is your book about? What's the title? And what motivated you to write it?
I've always had an imagination. Mm-hmm. When I was a kid, I used to write music. Used to write poetry, and my first book, The Neighbor, is a thriller, murder mystery. Mm. So I started with that one, and it was more of a protection project, which turned out to get a lot of reviews, and all of a sudden it was doing really well. And I have a lot of different ideas, and I sat down to write a sci-fi, completely different genre than a murder mystery. It is a sci-fi, but it's based off of true facts. So you get a lot of history in there, but it's told through a story. The name of my second book is called Tilt Magic Eights, and it follows two teens that inadvertently open up a vortex. So it's about time travel, meeting new worlds, dimensions,
and
they evolve, and it teaches them not only how to live without amenities and technology, but to really get in touch with what is the truth. So you see the teens evolve, and it's a beautiful story.
And I'm curious, are some of your characters Latino in the awesome.
Both,
yes.
Mixed, because I didn't want to be only Latino to bring up Latino and to support Latinos. I mean, that is a given. But I want to mix. I want stories that bring us together. You know, that intertwine us together as opposed to separate us and just be Latino story or an English story.
Yeah, because that's reality.
That's reality.
That's our thing about being in other films that are not Latino. Mm-hmm. We live in that world, too. So you're doing the same thing. You want it to be a realistic world.
And the characters are involved with each other. It's not like over here on this side
they're
of the tracks.
Segregated.
No, not segregated at all. Mm-hmm. So I really bring everybody together, which is, it's a melting pot, which is how we should live, all as one. Yes.
And so how can people find out more about when your book is going to be ready, to buy the other book? Tell us.
The Neighbor is already out. You can get it on Amazon. And Tilt will be out August 8th because it's Tilt Magic 8th, August 8th, 8-8.
Oh, okay.
There's a theme there.
Thank you so much for joining us. It's been wonderful.
Thank you for having me. And congratulations.
Thank